From San Francisco, California, this is the Rock and Roll Geek Show.
This is the story of my rock and roll butler.
Welcome to the Rock and Roll Geek Show. My name's Michael Butler. Thanks a lot for joining me. I really appreciate it. Today is Wednesday, August 24th, 2022, and it is 4:31 p.m. when I'm recording this. I just got back to San Francisco. Yippee! I got to go to work tomorrow, flying out on Friday, assuming the flights all go as planned. I'm really in need of a beer. First one of the day, I'm drinking a fine Tecate. Ah, that's good. First one of the day, always the best. I have an audio comment from Blake Johnson, but I'm going to do a little opening Butler's mail, if that's okay. I arrived in San Francisco to three pieces of mail addressed to me, so let's open them right now, shall we? Anything else I need to talk about? Not really. All right, I'm opening what seems to be a record album from McCracken's. All right, is this could be? I'm assuming that Sandy Hyde sent me this, okay, or his record label. All right, let's see. Thanks for all the support over the years. Please consider this payola, not that there's anything wrong with that. Spot McCracken. It is a vinyl 12-inch of Spot McCracken's solo album called New Tricks. Looks like it's a heavy vinyl. It's very, very good quality product here. Bunch of pictures of Spot McCracken on the back. It's got 10 tracks. Roll Over is side one, and side two is Play Dead. All songs written by Spot McCracken except Liliana and Take Me for a Walk by Spot McCracken and Chris Damien Dahl from Norway. It's got an insert with lyric sheets. All right. And it looks like it's on 180 gram gray splattered vinyl. You know what? I'm going to probably play one of these songs. So let's see. Let's do Roll Over. I will, let's see, we'll do that in a minute. I'll load this up while Blake Johnson's thing is going. Hold on, I got another piece of mail here. All right, pull out my little trusty Swiss Army knife, Victorinox, whatever you call them. All right, this is a letter from Jay Slibowski from Carlisle, Illinois. Jay, thank you, Jay. So let me open this up. Is it a birthday card? So what if you're getting older? Try to look on the bright side. It is a birthday card. White Lies band song suggestion. Roll December. Not considered rock, but I dig them. Jay Sablisky. Keep up the great content. Couldn't find you card, so happy birthday. Thank you, Jay. Roll December. Jay, if you send me that, by the way, it's $70 in here. Thank you so much, Jay. I really appreciate that. I'm going to have to thank you on today's show. Please send me that song, or don't send me, because it would just be wrong, and I will not play it on the next Rock and Roll Geek episode, okay? I don't have time to look for it right now, so please, if you're listening to this, please send it to me. If not, I'll try to look for it myself when I get off work tomorrow. All right, one more thing to open. It's an Amazon package. All right, I believe Michael Street sent me this, because I saw I got an email from Amazon. Let's open it here. I know this Butler's opening Butler's mail could be a little boring, but hey, not boring for me. This is value for value, friends. All right, it says, a gift receipt. Okay, gift for you. Hope you can get some use out of this in Florida from Michael Street. All right, first thing, venison rub. I did not get a venison. I hunted last night. Only a doe came under the tree stand. I would have shot it, but you're not allowed to shoot doe. Mountain seasoning venison rub, but I will put this on whatever else. Maybe I'll get a deer when I get back. We'll see. And I'm going hunting in Florida in November. Thank you, Michael Street. Also, a EK7000 4K Wi-Fi action camera with remote control. It's what do you call it? A GoPro. Michael Street, I'm going to bring this to Florida with me, And I will shoot some video. I'm assuming you can put it underwater. I'm going to assume that you can, but I will open it up and look. What's in the box? Action camera, waterproof case. There you go. Remote control, battery charger, battery mount, helmet mount, clip, full package. I'm bringing it to Florida with me, Michael Street. I will post some video. The GoPro. Thank you so much to everybody who sent me these lovely gifts. Much appreciated. I cannot tell you how that warms my heart, friends, to get value for value in the mail. Thank you, friends. I really appreciate it. All right, now it is time for audio comment. Blake Johnston, I believe it's Blake.
Michael Butler, it's Blake Johnston calling from Texas. Blake. With the first time, long time.
Hey, thank you for calling, Blake. It's nice to finally hear your voice, Blake Johnston. I really appreciate it, friend.
To a show review of John Waite, Men at Work, and Rick Springfield.
Yes.
But first and foremost, how you doing, man?
I am super great. Could not be
better. Man, I love hearing that. Yes. That's awesome. This is a show that happened last Sunday.
Hold on. I better say that fast. Let me back it up here. Okay. All right.
And Rick Springfield.
Okay.
But first and foremost, how you doing, man?
Super great. Couldn't be better.
Man, I love hearing that. That's awesome. This is a show that happened last Sunday, Sunday, August 14th,
okay.
Down at the Smart Financial Center in Sugar Land, Texas. Sugar Land, which gets a mention in the Stars song, Texas.
I did not know that.
Which is the B-side of Any Way That You Want It.
Any Way That You Want It.
It's a 6,500 seater.
Any Way That You Want It, I believe, from Attention Shoppers, right?
A pretty nice place. I've only been to two shows there. I saw Alice Cooper there with Ace Frehley a while back, and I think I printed the set list or posted the set list on the Rock and Roll Geek Show. Anyway, it's far enough away from the house where we decided we'd get a hotel. And
that's
so it's about 50 miles from where I live, which is in Spring, Texas.
You do not want to drive after drinking with Rick Springfield. I get and you're with the wife. He said he was with the wife, right? I think so. I was loading up Spot McCracken's vinyl here.
We drove down. I guess we left. I don't know. We left 3 o'clock. Got down there 4 or 5. Hell, I don't remember. Got something to eat. Well, no, actually, in the lobby, it was a funny thing. We're in the lobby, and there's these ladies, and I can hear them talking, and they're asking vaguely about, you know, well, where is the Smart Financial Center and all this stuff. The guy behind the desk is trying to point them in the right direction and all this stuff, and here's some people going to the show, and I never really looked twice. And then finally they got finished and they're walking away. And
are they MILFies? Because Rick Springfield concert, MILF Haven.
It was the first lady who had on this red t-shirt. She turns around and big as shit across the front, it says, "This grandma loves Rick Springfield."
Oh, yeah. Grill.
So like, oh, boy.
Gilf.
This is going to be one hell of a crowd.
Oh, hell yeah.
So we got all checked in.
By the way, I'll bet you hadn't, when you got to the show, he's probably going to tell me this, when you got to the show, no line for the men's bathroom, but the women's bathroom, that line's long.
We put our crap in the room, and we headed over, got something to eat, and went over to the venue, and you know, these things, they start early enough where I try not to panic about nobody being there because, you know, you want the bands
to
at least feel a vibe, you know, when they come to your town and everything. So it was pretty sparse looking, but it's a pretty big parking lot.
For John Waite?
So we parked and walked in. You know, we didn't really buy great seats. We were in the balcony, kind of where we were for the Ace and Alice Cooper show. So we had a good view. I mean, it's not unobstructed view from everywhere. I mean, it's just kind of far down there. So we walked in, and of course, you know, we're going to get a beer. You can't sneak anything in anymore. So we go up to the concession table, and I don't know.
At the very least, you take you get a Yeti knockoff 20-ounce tumbler and put that in the wife's purse because it's, you know, it's not beer. It's not in it. And when you get that plastic cup full of, when you put beer in a plastic cup, I've said this a million times, it tastes like horse piss. You might as well, it doesn't matter if you might as well be buying Falstaff or Bud. You can put a Trumer Pills or a high-class beer in a plastic cup and it tastes like Budweiser. So if you put, that's a little tech tip. Get your wife to bring a Yeti knockoff 20-ounce tumbler and pour the drinks in that and you can... You don't have to guzzle the beer before it gets warm.
a bunch of those big 20-ounce beers, and I just don't, I don't know, they just get too hot too fast.
Exactly.
I can't drink them fast enough, I guess.
Exactly. You just got a Butler Tech tip for you right there, friend. 20-ounce tumbler, that 20-ounce beer fits right in it.
And they were expensive as shit. They're 20-ouncers, and they had the Michelob Ultra in that thin line aluminum can. So we got a couple of those, and that was $25.
Yeah.
So I knew I had an investment working in my bar tab already. So there's a huge line for the merch, and there's this one table right there in the front, whereas, you know, before there was always two or three different tables when you went to shows back in the day. Yeah, I mean, at least that's the way I remember
it. Now these bands carry one merch person with them.
So anyway, we went over to the side of the merch table over there, because we just wanted to look. I don't need another concert shirt. Shit, I've got more concert shirts than I'll ever wear. Uh-huh. And my wife said she didn't want one either, but who knows how that was going
to
go.
Still actually, nice to
I
look
do
at
know
the merch.
How it was going
to
go.
Yeah,
so we're standing there, and we're about to go take our seats, and then some guy lumbers up pulling this little suitcase thing. And I don't know. He looked a little weird. He kind of hunched over. Long hair, kind of Ramonesy looking guy, long hair in a black suit with a bright purple tie, and he's pointing at a bunch of the merch and talking to the guy next to him, and then talking to the guy behind the merch table, and then I don't know, finally he opens that little satchel that he's dragging around. He pulls out all this this John Waite signed merch. Wow. And CDs and some
John
other
Waite
shit
fan.
In there. So I'm like, okay, check it out. That's my wife. I tell my wife, hey, check it out. Somebody's on merch duty. I said, I guarantee you he's in the band.
Oh,
so,
really?
I don't know. We went off. He was kind of, I could tell that he was in a hurry because it was almost time for the band to start by this time. And so we got up to our seats, and it was pretty nice. And, you know, there was really nobody around us. There might have been 2,500 people there. I mean,
for John Wayne?
I don't know. Maybe 2,500 tops. So anyway, lights go down, John Waite's logo comes up, and guitar player comes out, and it's not that guy from Matchbox 20 anymore. It's some guy named Mark Ricciardi or something.
I do not
so
know
he
anybody
was there,
in John Waite's
and
band.
Then John Waite comes out, and the drummer's kind of off to the side.
Yeah.
You're looking at the stage.
Yeah, I saw John Waite at a place called Yoshi's, and I believe the drummer was off to the side then, too.
He's kind of...
And I was disappointed in John Waite. I was so looking forward to seeing it. I was a little bit disappointed for some reason.
On the left of Minute Works drum set. It was awkward. No drum riser or nothing.
I wanted to do a quick set change.
Dude had zero cymbals. Huh. So, I don't know. I didn't know what to expect. John Waite comes out, and they're all just kind of strumming a little bit, and sure as shit, here comes that Ramonesy dude in the suit with the purple tie, the bass player. And I looked him up, and apparently his name is Tim Hogan. He's a good bass player, but I love that he has merch duty as well.
Nice.
So
low
they
budget,
bust off
man.
Into change, and it's pretty good. You know, it
change,
sounds good.
Change, people talking, the saying that you're leaving. Great tune, man. I love some John Waite. Let me see if I can find John Waite. John Waite. We all know how change goes. Back to you, Blake Johnson.
What I've noticed about John Waite is live, he takes a lot of liberties with his phrasing, you know?
Uh-huh,
and,
yeah.
And, you know, people
yeah,
at
you
these
know
concerts,
who else does
they
that?
Know how the song goes.
You know who else does that is Rob Halford. It kind of bugs me when the singers do that. I like to hear it sung right.
And they want to sing it, and boy, I tell you what, he was tripping them up left and right. The way he was kind of syncopating the way he sang this stuff. From change, he went into When I See You Smile. Which,
when
I
see you smile, is that broken? Is that broken English? I think it might be.
Fuck about bad English.
Yeah. Broken English, bad English. Broken Heart is the name of the baby's album. Bad English, yeah.
Sounded okay. My wife loved it, of course.
Of course.
Crowd was going crazy.
Oh, here it is. When I See You Smile, it's on. I've got it on Falling Backwards, a complete John Waite. Okay, we'll turn it up here. Is it on? Okay, a little John Waite. Yeah. This one for the ladies. There's no men here anyway.
Sometimes I wonder how I'd ever make it through.
How was his voice? Because he's got a great voice on these records, man.
And, you know, he did his best to keep them on their toes with his off-kilter singing.
Oh, really? His voice wasn't that great.
And that went over really well. He started throwing out a bunch of guitar picks. He had handfuls.
Oh, he's playing guitar?
He's just throwing them out all in the front rows, and people just diving for him. So goes from that into a song called Bluebird Cafe.
Bluebird Cafe. Is that on Rough and Tumble? I have Rough and Tumble. It's not on that. So I do not have that song, so don't know it.
I don't know. I guess it's okay. I mean, you know, it's like I was telling
you, let
me tell you what,
the dude's got a million hits.
Sounded okay.
Well, maybe he's got a new album he's trying to push.
My wife loved it, of course. Crowd was going crazy, and then, you know, he did his best to keep them on their toes with his off-kilter singing.
Oh, that's too
bad. That went over really well. He started throwing out a bunch of guitar picks. He had like handfuls, and he's just throwing them out all in the front rows, and people just diving for him. So goes from that into a song called Bluebird Cafe.
Sorry, backed it up too far.
I don't know. I guess it's okay. I mean, it's like I was telling my wife, let me tell you what I want in a John Waite show.
It doesn't have
anything to do with the fucking Bluebird Cafe.
I agree with you wholeheartedly. I just said that, Blake. You and me on the same page, man.
I'll tell you that. Anyway, I guess there's some sentimental story.
I love Blake Johnson. He's got a fucking... This is a great comment. Thank you, Blake. Please keep him coming, man. You got... As Adam Carolla says, I like the cut of his jib.
There he started talking about imagining some girl who got off the bus in Nashville.
Here we go, the story.
Blah,
blah, blah. He could have got two songs in.
Went from that into Missing You.
I ain't missing you at all. Missing you. Since you've been gone away. Yeah. You missing you. Hey, I like that song. I'm sorry.
And at that point, I realized, man, I think they're tuned down about half a step.
His voice ain't
so,
the same.
I mean, it sounded good. And the crowd's eating it up.
I ain't missing you at all.
Of course.
And John Waite was good in his day.
It was all pretty organic. All acoustic.
And the babies as well. Michael Corby. And Wally Stockard.
You know, the bass player is the only guy who was plugged in. Like I said, the drummer didn't have any cymbals. It was an interesting sound. From there, they went into Midnight Rendezvous, which was, you know, so fun.
Butler's played this one. Wait a minute, how's it go? Butler's played this song. I can't remember how it goes. Shit. Yeah, that's how it goes. We need to spend some time alone. We need to make some dreams come true. I wanna feel you touching me. I want a midnight rendezvous. All right, you've heard me sing. We don't need to hear him sing it.
I mean, probably my favorite song, and it's not even a good baby song, if you ask me.
That's one of my least favorites, believe it. It's kind of boring to play for me, too. I mean, it's a good song. It was a roller skating tune when I was a kid, but there's a lot of good babies tunes.
They did a good job of it, and John Waite sounds great, man.
Oh, good.
You know, he's still got the pipes, that's
good,
for
that's
sure.
That's good. He's got an original voice. You always know it's John Waite when you hear that song, when you hear that voice on record. That makes a great singer.
And he puts down his guitar. I don't know, he's rambling on about something.
You know, he played bass in the Babies. The first two Babies albums, he was playing bass. Played a Zimatis, and I think he might have played a Gibson Les Paul studio at some time, in the 60s Les Paul studio bass. Although, I could be wrong about that. I thought I saw him playing that on the Mike Douglas show, but it could have been a Zimatis.
And they bust into a whole lot of love.
What the? Yeah, you know, now that you mention it, he might have played that when I saw him too. We don't need to hear no fucking Whole Lot of Love.
Led Zeppelin. And I mean, don't get me wrong.
It's a fine song, but there's too many Babies tunes he can play.
A killer version of it, but once again, it's a John Waite show, man.
Yes.
I mean, am I wrong to think that?
No, he could have melted chicks' hearts with every fucking Babies hit and John Waite hit. They're all panty creamers, as we called it, said in the Featherwitch. We called the songs for the ladies panty creamers. He's got a million panty creamers, and he's got to pull a Whole Lot of Love out.
Better songs he could do than a Whole Lot of Love. I don't know. Good job. Boom. That was the end. Walks
what?
Off stage.
What? What? You got to be fucking kidding me, man. I would have been pissed off.
Six fucking songs. I couldn't fucking...
No Head First, No Broken Heart, No Back on My Feet Again, shit, I gotta get pull out the Babies catalog. Let me see, Babies. Baby, let's see all the Babies tunes that he did not play that they're hits. Let's pull up. Come on, Babies. Come on, Babies. The Babies. Isn't it time to rip down? Isn't it time? Head First. Back on My Feet Again. Give Me Your Love. Every Time I Think of You. Looking for Love. If You Got the Time. Yeah, I would have been pissed off, man. Broken Heart, Isn't It Time? Give Me Your Love. If You Could See Me Fly. Golden Mile. Broken Heart, I'm Falling, Rescue Me. Silver, Piece of the Action. Yeah.
Unbelievable, man. So, anyway.
I would have been flipping bird. I would have gone to the merch booth. I don't know if he would have been back. I would have said, man, you guys need to change your set list up. Whole Lot of Love.
Hey. It was time for us to go down to the bar again. Of course, there was a bar on our floor, too, which was, actually down one flight of stairs. So I go down there, and I get another $25 worth of Michelob Ultra. So I'm in.
That's the kind of show that people watch, though, man. It's fun watching people at these kind of shows.
$50 on beer.
Yeah, that's how it goes.
Get back up there, and we're sitting down waiting for Minute Work to come on, and I have no idea who would be in that band at this point.
Who knows? Colin Hay is the only person I know. I only know two songs. I Come From a Land Down Under, and I think that's all I know.
Hay has to be in the band. And the reason that we wanted to go see this show was because we had watched a documentary or an expose or like an insightful program, whatever it was, called Waiting for My Real Life, which was about that guy and Minute Work and what he's been doing. It was just super compelling.
Oh, okay.
If you haven't seen it, I suggest you watch it.
Waiting for Real Life.
He played soon after, in Houston, and it had been sold out for months. It was right around the COVID
times. Wow, who knew Minute Work was so
popular? We didn't get to see him. I really wanted to see that. But so it's Minute Work, and whatever that means. So they come out.
Does it matter?
And, you know, it's Colin Hay, of course, and then there's some other people on stage with him. And I don't know, man. It's just I was like, man, I don't think that's anybody from Minute Work.
Of course
except
not.
For Colin Hay, which
of course
is fine
not.
For me.
Yeah.
They busted
Nobody
out
cares.
With some song. I don't know what the first song was. I'm not super familiar with
me
Minute
neither,
Work.
Man.
I just felt compelled to get
Land Down Under. That's all I know.
To go because of
Vegemite Sandwich
of them being on the bill, and then he played. A song called Down by the Sea.
Don't know it.
And there was a drum solo in it. Can you believe that?
Oh, fucking drum solo. Do you think chicks want to hear a drum solo? Come on.
Like a second song and there's a drum solo.
Wow.
So he's got
an
all-studio musician type band. And then there's two girls
dudes.
In the band. Sheila Gonzalez, who's playing saxophone, flute, and keyboards. And then there's... Cecilia Noel, who my wife described as the chick with the yellow hat that walks around playing the tambourine.
Oh boy, must be.
She was really good.
Guess: Colin Hay's girlfriend or wife,
background vocals,
or daughter.
So anyway, there's a drum solo in the second song. Then he played "I Can See It in Your Eyes."
Don't know it.
Not familiar. It's okay. Dr. Heckle and Mr. Jive.
Don't know
what
it.
A great tune, man.
Don't know
I
it.
Really enjoyed that. Bad ass to hear it. No Sign of Yesterday.
Don't know
semi-familiar
it.
With. Then he starts introducing the band.
We like
apparently
the
they're
band.
All based out of Los Angeles. But
bunch
they all
of session
have,
guys
like,
from L.A.
Cuban and Latin American heritage. And
bunch of Cuban guys, session dudes from L.A.
Mention of that. And then they go into Overkill, which
Don't
is
know
great.
It. Don't know
That's
it.
On my poolside playlist. We listen to that quite a bit. And then It's a Mistake.
Don't know it.
Which I really like. A great song with that... kind of upstroke sound to it, really cool.
Flank, flank,
and then,
flank,
you know, everybody's flank. Favorite, Who Can It Be Now?
Who? Oh, yeah, that's the other hit. Who Can It Be Now?
Crowd goes nuts. They don't care that it's just Colin Hay.
No,
they think they're seeing
Men
at Work, even
nobody
though it's really people at work.
People at work.
Because they're too
there you
lazy.
Go, yeah.
And
who knows what they identify as.
Then he goes on, talks a little bit about the band and the tour and all the stuff. Then he does Land Down Under.
I come from a land down under.
And then they finish
under.
Up with Be Good.
Don't know.
Which is another great song. I'm just super enjoyed that set.
I'm glad, man.
I can handle it that it's just him because I'm not super familiar with him. I just like the songs. So.
That's good.
Anyway, well, it's time for another beer. Uh-huh. Another $25 yeah.
$75
bar tab.
You're $75
so we're
in.
$75 at that point. And
I hope you got laid. We go sit down. You know what?
My wife says she's going to the bathroom. Uh-oh. I knew what that meant.
Yep, long line for the women's bathroom.
Of course, she comes back with a Rick Springfield shirt.
Ah,
and
she didn't need no merch.
I don't know. We weren't sitting there too long before the lights went down. And it was a much bigger production, of course, when he came out.
Yeah.
And he comes out, he's bounding around, you know. The guy's, I don't know, 72 or 73.
Looks great. He's had work done, but he still looks great.
And that guy's fit, man. Yeah. And not just...
That's why all the chicks are there.
Not just, I mean, John Waite looks great. And that Colin Hay guy, I mean, they're all fit. But, I mean, this guy seems pretty athletic.
Yeah.
And he bounds out there, and they're open up.
I recommend his book, his autobiography, his memoir, whatever you call it. It's a really entertaining book.
The Affair of the Heart.
It's an affair of the heart. Yeah, you know how that goes.
And the crowd's going crazy.
Damn to believe it's an affair of the heart.
I could see that lady from the hotel lobby, grandma who loves Rick Springfield, was way up front.
Oh, good.
And then...
I'm sure Rick was happy about that.
He kind of says hello. They go into
hello.
I get excited.
Let me see. I get excited. That's on. Is that on the first album? Man, he's got some good songs, too. Oh, no, it's on Success Hasn't Spoiled Me, second album, or second. That's a great tune, man. Rick Springfield's fun live. Well, you admit you like the game, but you're not gonna play. You just ignore. Song is great. Great. I got the feeling that man, I was fucking geeking out when I've seen him a few times. I geek out every time. I went to see B.B. Buell play at the Roxy a long time ago with my wife, and Rick Springfield was in the audience, and I fucking geeked big. I was like a schoolboy. And we're both gonna win, and I think this angel's about to sin. I get excited, just man. I love this shit. Yeah, I love it. I'm sorry. I fucking love it, man. I love it.
And that's a pretty cool song.
Yeah.
And then, I don't know, all of a sudden there's like this beat drop and this video screen behind him.
Uh-huh. He does the same show every time, too. Both times I saw him, it was pretty much the exact same show.
Parks up and he starts talking about Sammy Hagar.
I've done everything for you. You've done nothing for me. I've done everything for you, which is on... Shit, it's not on the first album. It's on Working Class Dog. Working Class Dog. A little bit, I've done everything for you. You know, you've heard Sammy Hagar's version.
You know, I did one of Sammy's songs and all this stuff, and Sammy can't be here tonight, but through the magic of TV, he's going to join us.
Ah.
I'm like, oh, shit. And then all of a sudden, here comes Sammy Hagar, virtual Sammy Hagar on the screen, and then this background track and these backing vocals and all this shit starts up. And they do a song called Party at the Beach Bar.
Party at the Beach Bar.
And Sammy's singing virtually, and I don't know. It was basically, it was just Rick Springfield playing guitar and singing. Everything else seemed piped in.
Boy, dear, I've done everything for you.
Whatever. I don't hate it. It's just super corny.
Yeah.
And then, of course, while we're on the subject of Sammy Hagar, he does I've Done Everything for You. And that went over well.
Yeah.
World Stop Turning was another one of those things, which it was just all backing tracks.
Really? The guy's using fucking tracks? Rick Springfield, what is with you, man?
Move of this set, that's for sure. State of the Heart.
State of the Heart? What's State of the Heart? State of the Heart. Do I have State of the Heart? State of the Heart. Let me do Heat of the Heart. Oh, it's on Orchestrating My Life. Okay, that's an orchestra version, but it's only one I have. I'm not going to play an orchestra. That record's kind of bogus.
And that sounded good. Then he does like a medley.
Medley?
It has, I don't know, I was trying to keep track of what was in it. Heart of the City, She Called Me Bruce, and then a little piece of 867-5309.
What the hell?
And he
hell?
Says something in there about how everybody thinks he did that song, yeah. Which was pretty funny. Goes into Don't Walk Away.
Don't Walk Away.
House on Fire. Okay. Not familiar. What kind?
House on Fire. Let's see. House on Fire. House. I don't know that. How about Don't Walk Away? Don't have that either. Okay.
Kind of Fool. Not familiar. Fool, Working no. Class Dog. I know
okay,
that
working
one.
Working Class Dog. Okay.
All Right Tonight. It was a good one.
Love is all right tonight.
Don't talk to strangers.
Don't talk to strangers. That's when he gets the crowd going. He walks out into the audience with the microphone, and he has everybody go, don't talk to strangers. And the women sing off key, and they melt, and he makes fun of them. It's a fun time. Audience gets into it.
Human Touch.
We all need the human touch. I need it. Let me find American Heartbreak doing Human Touch. Let me see. Men. I wanted to do this song, and let me see, Human Touch? Why isn't American Heartbreak? Well, I don't have American Heartbreak doing it. American Heartbreak, okay. American Heartbreak, we all need the Human Touch. Why do I not have it on here? It's a demo, but I like our version. Human Touch, don't have it. Oh, here it is. Okay, Human Touch, Take 5 mix. Demo version. We all need. Let me play a little bit longer. I know I'm living on the outside, scared of getting caught. I told the band I wanted to do Human Touch, and they all looked at me like, are you fucking crazy, man? But I talked them into doing it. We never did it in an actual studio. Four-track cassette. He's got the love walking riding on the bed. You got like a woman. Come on, girl. We all need the human touch. We all need the human touch. I need it. The human touch. American Heartbreak.
And that went over really
well. Toot my own horn.
Oh, You Better Love Somebody.
You better love somebody. Oh, yeah, you better love somebody. That's a great one, too. Now I got to pull up all this shit. I'm geeking out. I'm Rick Springfield. Love Somebody. Okay. No, wait a minute. Love Somebody. Now, here we go. From Hard to Hold. It's a great tune. So 80s, but it's a catchy tune. All right, don't bore us. Get to the chorus. I can see the path you're cutting. It cost me a little piece of my heart. I can see the doors you're shutting. Let's get it to the chorus. Humor me, friends, while I geek out on Rick. Man, when I went to see him play, I was standing next to all these fucking MILFies. I'm the only dude there except for a couple of schlub husbands who had to come. I'm the only dude there by myself, and I'm screaming. Ralph Miller was ushering this show. I'm screaming the lyrics. I'm singing along. You better love somebody. Oh, I look so fucking gay.
Of course, he finished off with Jesse's Girl. So, I mean, it was a strong...
And then when he left, he played... when I saw him, the exit music was... Let me find it. This song was the exit music, which I love. A stupid title, but I love this
Tell
too.
Me her name, because I really want to see
her. Oh, man,
this
song is fucking great. From Venus in Overdrive.
Tell me her game, because I need an exit strategy.
This album's got some good tunes tragedy. On it.
But I know she's not much better.
This is what they played when the crowd was leaving. Hey, Rick, why don't you just play it live, dude?
I know she'd rather fly. Someone else's arms. Oh, it's true, the world wants
song is great.
Mystery, but I need to know one thing. What's Victoria's secret? Tell me if the clothes she wears.
Ah, this song is good. I love Rick Springfield. I'm so fucking gay, but I love him.
Show me that face. Is it really?
All right, I'm going to stop it. I'm going to go into a Rick Springfield nerd session. Back to you, Blake.
That on the last few songs, of course, you know, all these women had been bringing up these big bouquets of...
Those are plants. They hand these flowers to these chicks. He does windmills. Both times I saw him play... A girl brings up flowers. He does windmills on his guitar, and the flowers are all getting destroyed, and rose petals are going everywhere. That's what he's going to say, right, Blake?
Roses. I mean, just like there was a bunch of them right at the front of the
plants.
Stage.
Plants.
So during one of the last songs, I thought it was hilarious. He showed his appreciation by he pick up the flowers, and I can't even remember what
Windmilling.
Song they were playing. And he decided to flail his guitar with the roses, and of course, it's shredding them all
over
the
place. Part of
the
act. It looks good, but it's part of the act.
And I don't know. Maybe it's an honor to have Rick Springfield shred your roses.
I'm telling you, they give these women these roses and say, please put these roses up there.
On
telling
stage.
You.
Anyway, it was...
Or maybe they're just such super fans, they know he's going to do it, so they bring the roses.
Fun night. We spent the night out in Sugar Land, Texas.
Sounds like a fun time, man.
It was an early night.
Hell yeah.
So got up and got out of there fairly early, but great show. Glad to be able to come on here and give
Thank you
a review.
Blake.
I just want to make sure that... everybody knows that Rick Springfield uses a lot of background tracks.
That sucks.
Anyway, stay frosty, my friend.
Stay frosty,
we'll talk to
Blake.
You soon.
Please call in again, Blake Johnson. I love your audio comments. He's got a great attitude. Everybody who's on the Rock and Roll Geek Facebook group, man, I'm telling you, they're all cool people. If anybody in the Rock and Roll Geek Facebook group, if you all meet up, ask Joe Pollack, everyone. They're all nice people. Thank you, Blake Johnson. I really appreciate it, friend. You too can leave me an audio comment or a show review or your first concert that got you into rock and roll. Whatever, like I said, tell me I'm an asshole. Record it in your phone and send it to me at rockandrollgeek@gmail.com. Thank you, Blake. I really appreciate it, friend. All right, that's going to do it for me. One more day before I head to Florida. I'm going to maybe do a few audio comments tomorrow and maybe do a little bit longer of a show. We'll see. So if I land okay in Florida, I'll be doing one from the hotel room in the South Beach of Miami. All right, let's pull up Spot McCracken. I'm going to play the first song on the album. Let's make sure the vinyl's going here. Liliana. Spot McCracken on drums and vocals, Chris Damian Dahl, rhythm and lead guitar, and Bill McCracken on bass. All right, let's see here. Chris Damian Dahl, a special guest on this track, and he co-wrote it. So hopefully this is playing. Let me see it. Maybe it's not. Let's see. Oh, here we go. Okay, now it's working. We drop the needle. We might as well do the...
And now... It's time for the Rock and Roll Geek Vinyl Track of the Week.
Yeah, all right, thank you, Dave Jackson. All right. Oh, okay. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Thank you for listening, friends. I'll talk to you tomorrow. You know how to reach me.
It's a rock and roll geek train wreck.